I don't even know who you are.
My name's Aiden.
And I'm Charlotte. Thank you, Aiden.
Nah, it's nothing. Wait here for me. Luan, it's Aiden. Come in. Luan? Come on, Luan, answer me. You there? Ah, great. I fixed the transmitter and now you go radio silent.
Night Runner? Never occurred to me. Not in a million years.
On Radio Free Villador. Your neighbor, your city, once more and forevermore. Signing off.
Talk to me, Frank.
Look, we started off on the wrong foot. I'd like to correct that mistake. Have a drink. Yeah? For me.
Frank, I really don't have time for this. I have to find another way to find my...
Just listen.
Walt needs to access that jarring place. You get it? That's why we have to find that pilgrim. He's offering a lot of fucking crystals for what he's got. And a lot of boosters.
Do I have your attention now?
With those?
Renegades. Yes.
But how did you...
The TV station used to be controlled by the military. They did more than just broadcast from there. Thanks to you, we can now listen in on the enemy. It appears that Waltz is looking for the same database you're after.
But the observatory is completely soaked with chemicals.
I have no idea how this GRE crap works, but Waltz sure seems to know. Maybe the observatory's not the only place to access the database.
Is this conversation all you have?
For now. But if we got close to their position and hacked into their frequency, we could collect more intel on Watts' plans.
How?
The transmission you heard was intercepted near an old military antenna in the wharf, just south of Marsh End Lane. If we activate that antenna, it'll boost the signal, and we'll be able to hear everything they say. Every syllable. And you'd know exactly what Waltz is up to.
It'd be quicker if I could just find him.
You're impatient, I understand. I know what it feels like to have wasted too much time. But you have to tread carefully. Remember, you said Waltz turned the power back on. Then the Renegades invaded the Central Loop. There's something going on, so best to collect as much intel as we can before you confront him.
Tell me more about these antennas.
The military installed them on the tallest buildings to blanket the entire city. They're extremely hard to access, but all we need is the one nearest to where those Renegades were based. When the signal's stronger, we'll be able to hear everything they say. Now, the good thing is, it's the closest antenna to the canteen. You shouldn't have trouble finding it.
So, you think Waltz ordered the Renegades into the Central Loop?
Well, until now, the Colonel kept him on a short leash in his stronghold. But the savages we've been seeing lately... What the fuck? Something must have changed.
One of the PKs told me that Waltz is after something called, X-13.
Doesn't ring any bells.
Right, anything else before I get going?
Oh, one more thing. Look at that poster, Aiden. Night Runners used to abide by that creed, live by it. I used to think we were as torn apart as that piece of paper, but the creed still means something. And if you increase the range, I can contact the remnants of the old Night Runners. Some must still be alive.
I see it now. This means a lot to you, doesn't it?
Not just me. To everyone here. But there's one piece missing. Do you know why I haven't thrown this poster away in all this time? Because of Luan. When I saw her for the first time, she was maybe, 8, 9 years old. She was barely alive. She looked like she hadn't eaten in a year. And she was trying to help some kids get a crystal back from the thief. The guy was threatening them with a knife. He was twice their size, stronger, and she jumped on him. Bit his hand so deep that his screams were heard as far away as Old Villador. After that, she gave the crystal to one of the boys and left. She didn't get anything out of it. She didn't have to risk it. I looked at her and thought, this is all we have left. As humans, we can fight one another. Everybody just for themselves. Or, no matter what, we can stand up for each other. Then I wrote down this credo. That little girl helped the Nightrunners become who they were for years. And if we are to be reborn, we cannot do it without her.
Why not without her?
You see, she's a tough one. Maybe too tough. I trained her, helped heal her wounds, but never healed the biggest one. Revenge. She's built a mighty thick wall around herself. Can't seem to let go of her anger. If she doesn't, it could destroy her. I know. Drunk calling the kettle black, right?
I'm in no position to judge, Frank.
Thanks. Luan's so fucking obsessed with her kill list. She needs to throw that damn thing away.
Otherwise, it'll kill her.
Let's hope she's better fighting them than I am.
What are Luan's demons?
Almost too many to count. But Satan himself is at the top.
You mean Hakon?
You know him?
Yeah, we've met.
It all came down to the TV station mission. Hakon was against that from the start. Got Killian on his side. He said it was suicide. But I know the truth. The fucker chickened out, plain and simple. Till then, he wasn't just a Nightrunner to me. I thought he was leader material. But he didn't have our backs. Tore the Creed in half before he bolted, and with it, tore apart the Nightrunners themselves. Fucking coward. Didn't deserve to lick Luan's boots. Look, I'm starting to get pissed off, and we should focus.
What about Hakon killing Lucas? That took some balls.
Sure, but they weren't his balls, they were Waltz's. Hakon's just the guy's lapdog now. Sit, roll over, assassinate.
That's true. Neutered dogs are even more obedient than they were before.
Exactly.
Okay, I'm on my way.
Then go get him. I'll be on the radio. You remind me of Luan, before she became obsessed with that goddamn hit list of hers. I'll get ears on the Renegades for you. I'll find out what Waltz is up to. I promise. Good day, Villador. Frank is back, and I've got some more exciting news for you. Blankets, food, and drinking water are being collected at the canteen. All those in need can report to Nicholas. Stay tuned, and I'll be back soon with another...
Warcast. It's a source of hope.
How you doing, buddy?
Dead.
Nicholas, I'm in the control room.
Nice. Now just find the switch.
Nicholas, the switch didn't work.
Damn it. There's another way. Forgive me to try?
Let's finish this.
There should be an electrical room with military generators further below. Look for an elevator. Maybe you can go down the shaft.
What are military generators doing in the metro?
Seems the tunnels work great for moving troops around the city. Only first they had to clean the infected out. And to do that, they needed a lot of light. That called for a lot of power. Thank you.
Nicholas, it worked. Generators are up and running.
So the intel wasn't some booze-induced fantasy. Now get back up here. I got some beers on ice with your name on them.
Ah! wrong here.
They said he's gone to the dogs.
Over here.
one seeing this. Want some of this? It's on now. Yeah. Attack, man. This is nuts. Man, you're slow. Thank you.
Taking here doing jobs others wouldn't, and spending every penny on medication. We'd return with the medicine and set up our families for life. I'm not proud of what we did, but we did it. At the end of the year, we went home. When we got to Leipzig, it was surrounded by bandits and slavers. One day, Bernard returned with a woman who claimed to be a pilgrim. She agreed to see us through bandit territory for a bottle of Antizin, already very valuable at the time. She knew every path, hiding spot, bandit camp for miles, knew how to avoid the infected. She kept us close to the Elbe River as if she was tracking something. Finally, we reached the crossing and we were very close to home. But the Pilgrim, she insisted that we wait until morning. I was restless, so close to home. Something moving in the camp woke me in the middle of the night. I saw the Pilgrim slinking into the woods with our meds. But before I could wake Bernard, slavers attacked the camp and overpowered us. They threw us into their ramshackle boat moored nearby. We were a prize, as the other slaves on the ship were children. And they were tipped off by the Pilgrim, who'd made it.
Nothing wrong with that.
What's he doing to me?
Now I'm pissed. Oh, now.
What I wish to become, I will be a master flautist, a virtuoso. Uh-huh.